A new study from the Southwest Autism Research and Resource Center may change the paradigm of diagnosis. The American Academy of Pediatrics suggests kids be first screened for autism at 18 months. The study started screening kids at their one-year well baby checkup 6 months earlier than recommended. As Courtney Friedman explains, that's resulted in diagnoses and treatment years earlier.
Aiden DiCarlo was diagnosed with autism at 19 months old in the early intervention study. He's come to the Southwest Autism Research and Resource Center, or SARC, for nearly a year.
The big things that we see are in socialization. He enjoys playing around with friends. He really enjoys coming to school.
Before he came here, there were tantrums because he couldn't communicate. In fact, his mom says he was communicating at a five-month-old's level.
He's now at between a 2 and a 2.5. So in 9 months, he's gained about a year and a half.
SARC Research Director Christopher Smith launched the study 5 years ago. 109 pediatricians used a standard questionnaire in well baby checkups at 12, 18, and 24 months. Diagnosis age plummeted from 55 months to an average of 22.
We want to act on those early warning signs and get parents to seek an evaluation sooner so they can get into treatment sooner.
Families were referred to SARC if screenings showed delays. Aiden was getting help more than 2 years before he might have been diagnosed outside of the study.
We took all of that lost time that happens as a result of the standard procedures for screening and diagnosis and gave that back to families that they can better spend on intervention and helping their children move forward.
To see him in the not even year that he's already been at SARC, how much he's progressed, it's just completely amazing.
Courtney Friedman, KSAT 12 News.
This study ended in June, but the early screenings and diagnoses will continue thanks to funding from Arizona Complete Health. Christopher Smith is working to expand use of the standardized questionnaire and to train more pediatricians and diagnosticians so families don't have to wait so long for diagnosis and intervention.